Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I say good morning to you today, and I bring fresh oil to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the topic of the fresh oil today is that the mountain of troubles in your life shall be leveled down. Every mountain in your life shall be leveled in the name of Jesus Christ. Have you observed that probably there is an obstacle standing in the way of your progress? Does it look as if you know, there are some barriers in the way of your destiny? Are there, you know, what you have observed to be an obstacle standing in the way of your progress? This morning, whatever is standing in the way of your progress, whatever it is that is slowing you down, whatever it is that has constituted a barrier that is not making you to move the way you are supposed to move forward in life, shall be removed in the name of Jesus Christ. It's not going to be by might. It's not going to be by power. Is going to be by the Spirit of the living God. In Zechariah chapter 4 and verse 6, hallelujah, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, it's not by might, it's not by power, he said, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. He said, who art thou, O great mountain before Zerubbabel? Who are you, mountain? He said, this mountain shall be leveled. Hallelujah. It shall become a plain. Therefore, I'm here to declare to you, that whatever mountain that is standing in the way of your progress, whatever it is that you have sensed, you have observed, that is a deliberate hold on your destiny that is not making you to advance forward, I'm here to declare to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that such mountain shall be removed, because the power of our God is more than enough to set you free. You are going to be set free from whatever obstacle, from whatever chain, from whatever barrier that is not making you to make significant progress in life. You are going to be set free in the name of Jesus Christ. I want you to know that removing mountain is not a problem with our God. Because before any mountain was formed at all, God has been God. Hallelujah. Oh, he knows the foundation of every mountain. So therefore, no mountain can be proud unto God. And probably the only mountain that can be proud unto our God is the mountain that God does not know his foundation. That God has not been God before the mountain was. And there's no such mountain. Because according to that scripture in Psalm 90, verses 1 and 2, he said, Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hast formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. That is, before any mountain was formed at all, you are God. Therefore, there is no mountain that can be proud before God. Hallelujah. Oh, there is no mountain whatsoever. Hallelujah. So, if that is the case, whatever mountain in your life, whatever challenge in your life, whatever obstacle, whatever barrier, God knows his foundation. So, it's not new. The power of God is more than enough to remove it. Hallelujah. That's why the mountain in your life is in trouble today. It must be leveled or it has to melt away. Because two things happen when God decides to visit, you know, the mountain of your life. Two things happen. It's either it will melt away or its foundation, its structure will be destroyed. Hallelujah. So let's examine what is it that will make a mountain to melt away. In Isaiah chapter 64, this is prophet Isaiah speaking and letting us know that when God comes down upon the situation of anyone, the mountain will melt away. In Isaiah chapter 64, verse 1, he said, oh, that thou would rend the heavens open, O God. That is, God, open the heavens, that you will come down, that the mountains might flow at your presence. Mountains might flow. He said, mountains will flow as if it has been melted with fire, as if water that is boiling. He said, that is the way it's going to melt away. And I'm here to speak to you in the name of the Lord, that every mountain in your life will melt away. It will melt away in the name of Jesus, because when God comes down, mountains must melt away. The other thing that happens when God decides to come down or to visit your mountain is that its structure, its foundation will be destroyed. Remember in Psalm 114, verses 1 to 4, the Bible says, when Israel went out of Egypt and the house of Jacob from the people of strange language, Judah was his sanctuary and Israel was his dominion. The Bible says the sea saw it and it fled. Jordan was driven back. And mountains keep like rams. Mountains keep like rams. And the little is like lamb. The moment mountain is keeping like rams, it means that its foundation has been destroyed. Hallelujah. The moment the foundation of any structure, of any building is destroyed, I'm sure you know that the integrity of such a building has been compromised. Therefore, today, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I command every mountain in your life to melt away. I command every mountain of barrenness to melt away right now. I command every mountain of unnecessary waiting for your glory to melt away right now. If your health has been a mountain, if there has been challenges in your health, today that mountain bows, that mountain melts away in the name of Jesus Christ. If some human beings have constituted themselves to become a barrier and a mountain, and they are standing in the way of your progress, I command them removed right now in the name of Jesus Christ. So from today, you will begin to make significant progress in life in the mighty name of Jesus. No barriers, no more obstacles are permitted in your life in the name of Jesus. You are blessed and you are highly favored. So today, go and prosper. It is well with you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah.